You look up into the sky and see a giant raindrop descending from the clouds above. You stare in wonder as all of the rain that would fall across the planet condenses into one single raindrop right above you. As the enormous glob of water gets closer and closer to the ground, the temperature where you're standing starts to increase. You begin to sweat, and in that instant you know something is terribly wrong. The water falls at over 300 miles per hour. You will be vaporized under its weight and pressure. But what'll happen to the rest of the world? First, we need to calculate how much rain falls across the planet each day, which is easier said than done. The daily rainfall across the planet differs as the weather is different every day. However, the average is somewhere around 260 billion gallons of water per day. This is a gigantic number. It'd be like taking a little over half of all the water contained in the Great Lakes, or around 400,000 Olympic-sized swimming pools, and forming it into a raindrop. Obviously, the first thing that comes to mind when you think of a giant raindrop falling from the sky is that there will be huge amounts of flooding wherever it lands. However, this is a rather insignificant problem for anyone and anything near the impact site. Getting a little wet should be the last thing on anyone's mind, as things are about to get so much worse. At a basic level, rain is created when the evaporated water from the surface of the Earth cools and condenses as it rises higher into the atmosphere, where the temperatures are lower. When these water molecules condense, they cluster together, which forms as a raindrop. When the drops of water become too heavy, gravity pulls it toward the surface of the Earth, and this process causes rain. Due to how the climate, chemistry, and physics work, there's no possible way that all of the rain across the planet could be condensed into a single drop. But if this somehow did happen, and a raindrop managed to contain 260 billion gallons of water, it would be just over 330 cubic miles in size, which is a little under 3 times the length of Switzerland from east to west. The raindrop would be so massive that it would completely block out the sky for anyone standing under it. The raindrop would weigh around 1 billion tons, so it's not hard to imagine how much damage it would do when it impacted the ground below. Rain condenses a couple of miles above the Earth's surface, so we'll assume that this is where that giant raindrop will form as well. At first, there would just be clouds. As the moisture in the air builds, the clouds would become more plentiful and darker. Then the amount of water in the sky reaches a point where the raindrop can form. The bottom of the cloud starts to bulge out. If you're looking up into the sky, it would look like something is pushing on them from the inside. The bottom of the raindrop would appear as if the clouds were giving birth. Everything goes black. And then all you can see where you look up into the sky is complete darkness. Even if it's the middle of the day, the sunlight would not be able to penetrate that much water and reach the surface of the Earth. We now have a 300 cubic mile raindrop containing 260 billion gallons of water that weighs 1 billion tons and is suspended above the surface of the planet where you are standing. The raindrop starts to fall. It accelerates to over 300 miles per hour as it approaches the surface. The water takes several seconds to reach its maximum speed. If you're standing underneath the raindrop as it plummets toward the Earth, you will be long dead before the water reaches you. The wind picks up directly beneath the raindrop. The massive bulk pushes a huge amount of air out of the way as it falls. This causes winds to blow outward at hundreds of miles per hour. People are swept off their feet. Entire forests are knocked over. Anything that is not bolted down gets swept outward, flattening the area directly under the giant raindrop. As the raindrop picks up speed, the bottom begins to foam. The air pressure increases as the water falls faster and gets closer to the ground. This causes waves to appear on the surface and flow up to the top of the raindrop. These ripples only happen for a few seconds. Once the massive sphere of water approaches the ground, something crazy happens. Right under where the raindrop will impact the Earth, the air can't move out of the way quick enough and therefore becomes compressed. This causes an incredible amount of pressure to build up. This high pressure also causes the temperature between the bottom of the raindrop and the ground to increase, which superheats the area. Whatever is directly below the raindrop will be incinerated just moments before the raindrop slams into the ground, covering everything in water. This would inevitably put out the flames, but there is something horrifying about the thought of watching a giant raindrop fall toward the Earth while you burn to death. The water you so desperately need to put the fire out would also crush you, but that's beside the point. Either way, you're not going to survive the impact of this raindrop. The pressure buildup on the underside of the giant raindrop would be so great that it would start to flatten the curve of the sphere of water. The water and anything inside the raindrop itself would experience much pressure as the bottom of the Marianas Trench. Hypothetically, if there was someone inside the raindrop, or an airplane full of passengers had the unfortunate luck of flying directly into the raindrop, people's eardrums would burst due to the change of pressure. Moments later, anyone and anything inside of the raindrop would be crushed under the insane pressure before impact. The giant raindrop reaches the surface of the Earth and slams into the bedrock at hundreds of miles per hour. The sheer weight of the raindrop releases terajoules of energy. It would be the equivalent of over 100 atomic bombs detonating all at once. Even though the raindrop is liquid, it would still create a massive crater at the impact site that would completely obliterate anything in its radius. Even as the ground underneath the raindrop is decimated, the solid bedrock of the Earth doesn't yield completely. The water contained in the raindrop is forced outward, and the land surrounding the impact site quickly becomes flooded by a humongous tidal wave. However, this is not just some ordinary tidal wave sweeping across the planet. The force of the impact causes the water to spray in all directions at incredible speeds. The flow of the water would be moving at close to supersonic speeds. Anything in the vicinity that was not consumed by the initial flood of water raining down from the sky would be completely erased from the face of the Earth due to the force of the wave moving across the landscape. People hundreds of miles away watch in horror as the tidal wave created by the giant raindrop wipes every living thing, structure, and geological feature from existence. They feel a slight breeze as the wave approaches, then the wind picks up as the water forces the air out of its way. People are blown off their feet as the initial spray of rainwater splashing their faces turns into a barrage of water. The tidal wave would have hit, and that'd be the end. The wave from the dispersed raindrop would be hundreds of feet tall. There would be no escaping the carnage. As the wave loses its momentum and slows down, it becomes less destructive. However, the flooding will be catastrophic. Depending on where the raindrop fell, entire countries could now be under miles of water. The water would eventually flow toward the lower elevations, and any hills or mountains that had initially been flooded would pop up above the waterline. New islands would appear to be sprouting out from flooded regions. In reality, these were just previously high areas of elevation. There would be nothing left on top of them, as any trees or buildings would have been completely pummeled by the initial force of the wave. However, the barren rock and mud that once contained life would eventually recover after several decades of ecological succession. Several hours after the water from the raindrop dispersed across the landscape, there is a stillness. If the raindrop landed in the middle of a continent, there would now be a gigantic lake where the land once stood. If it fell on Australia, there's a good chance the entire landmass would be underwater. On the other hand, if the raindrop fell into the ocean, the initial effects would be the same, except the tidal wave created would be much larger. The raindrop would displace a huge amount of ocean water and would send it careening across the planet at hundreds of miles per hour. The water that was forced outward from the impact would be immediately replaced by the water in the raindrop, meaning that coastal regions across the world would be flooded. The water from giant tsunamis would not flow back into the ocean, as the rainwater would be in its place. If the giant raindrop fell into the Atlantic, the eastern regions of the US, Canada, Central America, and South America would be flooded. The new coastline would be created much farther inland than it was before the raindrop had fallen. Western Europe, Great Britain, the western countries of Africa would all be mostly underwater. If the giant raindrop fell in the Pacific Ocean, East Asia, Australia, and island nations like the Philippines and Japan would no longer exist. The western coast of North and South America would also be rewritten, while areas like the Amazon rainforest and the prairie lands of the US would now have beachfront property. If all rain across the planet fell in a single drop, the destruction would be immense. 260 billion gallons of water weighing 1 billion tons falling at over 300 miles per hour is enough to incinerate, drown, and demolish anything in its path. There are likely repercussions that we can't predict depending on where the raindrop falls, but it's safe to say that if this gigantic raindrop ever did fall from the sky, it would completely change the geography of our planet. Now watch, what if the Earth stopped spinning, minute by minute? Or check out, what if Adolf Hitler woke up in the 21st century?